Hello, my name is Tanay Tiwari and welcome to Buzz This Week, a show that wants to be as gritty as PV Sindhu, as passionate as India's hockey teams, as determined as all of India's Olympians and yet manage to look as cool as MS Dhoni. Ab ye sab banne mein to samay, magar cricket news aur memes banne mein samay nahi hai from the week gone by. Wo tayar hai on the show this week. Sri Lanka versus India, the ups and downs. Stokes hits pause and New Zealand makes it count. The expectations from Team India before this Sri Lanka white ball tour started were much like crypto investors' key expectations from their bitcoins. Because everything was set. Team India looked good. This new look Team India looked very good. The talk around it being a B-side was shunned quickly and the performances on the field were translating the promise of it. Because India won the ODI series and then won the T20I as well, the first one. Then happened the Elon Musk equivalent to Team India. Kunal Pandya tested positive, several others were isolating, India had to make massive changes. Per India's head coach Rahul Dravid, they had to select the 11 that were available because only that many were available. India made 4 debuts, ensured that they brought in the net bowlers inside the squad. There were a lot of issues for Team India, which meant that Sri Lanka won their first ever T20I series against India in the history of the format, and there were positives aplenty for Sri Lanka. Especially that one man, Wanindu Hasaranga, with the bat, with the ball, his character on the field, he is a big plus and a big box ticked for Sri Lanka going forward because they have in that player a lot of pedigree. Something that the IPL teams are also looking at this moment. As for India, while there were a lot of positives, Deepak Chahar's all-round performance, Rahul Chahar spinning the ball so well, Suryakumar Yadav's 360 show again, there were issues as well. The biggest one being the inability of India's young batsmen to play spin. Devdutt Padikkal, Ruturaj Gaikwad, a little that we saw of them, they struggled against spin. Even some seasoned pros like Sanju Samson and Nitish Rana, who've played so much of spin, were struggling out there as well. They were like me in my chemistry exam, ki attempt to tha. Lekin samajh shayad pura nahi aa raha tha. Something that the Indian team management might have to keep an eye on. Samajh to is samay England ko bhi nahi aa raha hoga. Ben Stokes, whose return to Test cricket was being looked forward to after his injury in the IPL, has now pulled out of not only the India Test series, but perhaps further as well, because he says he wants to continue to work on his mental health while also nursing his finger. This was clarified by the ECB in their statement as well. And Twitter poured its support in for Stokes. But there are two pertinent points to Stokes' withdrawal. One, England will now have to scamper to find a balance in that side. Stokes not only has the best batting average amongst that batting lineup, but he also lends a lot of balance to that side with the ball, in the field, and also as a leader on the park. All of those roles will now have to be redistributed within that side. Perhaps we'll see Joe Root bowling more, especially with drying pitches in England towards the end of their summer. The second connotation to Stokes' withdrawal is the mental impact that relentless sport is having across all sports, especially in cricket, where the relentless cricket action post the pandemic sort of eased in the world has been for everyone to see. And it has started taking a toll on these players who stay within bio bubbles, which means there is no freedom of movement while they have to continue to perform at their best. This, while the threat of COVID-19 looms large within these bio bubbles as well, as we've seen at a number of occasions now, none of these bubbles are really impregnable. In the last week itself, we saw how Kunal Pandya tested positive while being inside a bubble, and now Shane Warne, the head coach of London Spirits in the 100, has also tested positive for COVID-19. All of this only adds to the mental pressure on a player within these bubbles. Then there are restrictions to bring family. Sometimes they're allowed, sometimes they're not. All of this just keeps piling on. And I think Stokes' case makes it very clear that even someone like a superstar in his own mind, Ben Stokes, if he's struggling with mental issues, there are issues to be talked about. And we're so glad that someone like Ben Stokes stood up and spoke for himself.
Tell me you're a cricket fan. without telling me you're a cricket fan.
Okay, challenge accepted. Here we go. Now, I looked at that footage and I didn't feel bad. That makes me a cricket fan. It does, right? I mean, when India lost to New Zealand in that World Test Championship final, you felt bad as an Indian fan. But then to watch New Zealand celebrate a well-earned world title after a number of years, it's just so heartening to see. It fills your heart with a lot of happiness because these guys deserved this world title. There'll be happiness in the Trans-Tasman rivals of New Zealand as well, as Australia finally managed to win something on that West Indies tour, winning the ODI series and marking a stamp of some sort of authority after a drubbing in that T20I series. While they now travel to Bangladesh, they still have a lot of loopholes to fill. But there's good news on other front as well, as their former captain George Bailey is now the head of the national selection panel for the Australian men's cricket team. He takes over from Trevor Horns, who was a part of that selection panel for 21 years. And with George Bailey around, you can be rest assured that Australian cricket is in good hands. As is Pakistan cricket, where Mohammad Hafeez, who's been, well, around for ages now, is still continuing to perform at the peak level for Pakistan. If he doesn't do it with the bat, he continues to do it with the ball, as was the case in the second T20I versus the West Indies, where his spell of 4 overs for just 6 runs strangled West Indies to such an extent that they not only failed to chase down 158, they had 6 wickets in hand and yet fell short by 8 runs, with Nicholas Pooran being out there batting, not out. That goes to show you the kind of impact that Hafeez's bowling has had on this very spirited Pakistan team. Your bus challenge this week comes with a bit of a concerning news. Now, if Ajinkya Rahane is unfit for the first test match, who do you replace him with? Who becomes your opener? Tell us using hashtag buzz this week, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, Twitter. Time kam hai pehla test shuru hone mein. Bhej dijiye apne answers. That's all that we have for you in this episode of Buzz This Week. Let's hope that when we meet next week, Team India has more medals in the Olympics than they have right now. Fingers crossed.